Now to study this cognitive function, what we have done that, this is, you are familiar, this row crowded application, 16 RPM, and this is the inclined plane angle at 60 degrees. So here, what you can see, that the point, salient point is that with hypertension 4B and 21 degrees Celsius, you can see that there is slight decrease in the function. Here it is also after 33 degrees, much more declining function. So when there is a combination of hypothermia, the cognitive function declines faster. Combination of the stress at 21 and 33, if the stress is put at high ambient temperature, the effect is worse. And even hypertension with silica at high ambient temperature, this is worse. But when we, this is a combination of three things: hypertension, silica, and immobilization stress. Particularly at 33, you see that cognitive function decline much faster and much severe than the other circumstances. So the message is that the stress, silica, and hypertension at high ambient temperature is worse. Then this is the inclined plane angle. They are following exactly almost in the same order. I just want to tell you that a combination of hypertension, silica, and immobilization stress at high temperature, 33 degrees Celsius, this is much more worse than their only immobilization for silica. So the point is that silica neurotoxicity is higher at 33. Immobilization stress, they are also greater at 33 degrees Celsius. And this leads to exacerbation of neurotoxicity. I will show you some examples here. Here we have measured regional blood-brain barrier permeability to radio ion. You can see the first two things, hypertension 21 and 33. There is slight increase, they're only hypertension. Then hypertension, silica, and immobilization. So this is, you can see 21 and 33, much higher increase in permeability. And the last two bars are hypertension and immobilization. No silica, 21 and 33. So although immobilization can increase, but at high ambient temperature, the results are worse. And these are different brain regions: cortex, hippocampus, striatum, thalamus, hypothalamus, brainstem, and spinal cord. But the message is very simple. Normally, whenever we have a breakdown of the barrier, proteins are entering into the brain and leads to brain edema. Making this is very simple. The first two are hypertension 21 and 33. Hardly there is any difference. Hypertension plus immobilization stress 21 and 23. You can see slight increase because the brain edema, even 0.5 or 1% increase is too much. This is because of the scale, you can't see that difference is much higher. But combination of hypertension and silica and immobilization, 21 and 23, you can see 33. You can see that 33 is highest among all different brain regions. Then neuronal damages. Of course, if we have increased permeability and edema formation, then the neuronal functions will be altered. And here is the example again, I'm making very simple. Hypertension plus silica, 21 and 33 degrees is higher. Hypertension and immobilization stress, 21 and 33 is always higher. But look at this, these drops. Hypertension, silica, and immobilization stress at 33 degrees centigrade is massive neuronal damage in all different brain regions that we have examined: hippocampus, striatum, thalamus, hypothalamus, brainstem, and spinal cord. 33 degree highest with silica and immobilization stress. These are the examples, all were immobilization stress. This is 21 combination of silica, and this is 33 combination of silica and hypertension. Whereas this is the hypertension and immobilization stress, only 21 and 33. So the combination of different kind of three kinds of stress, immobilization, hyperthermia, and even silica dust, they are compounded, resulting in brain damage. So at this moment, we can say that this silica oxide with hypertension and stress enhanced brain pathology. All effects were much more higher at 33 degrees Celsius as compared to 21. And the most important point is that if we had comorbidity factors, for example, hypertension or diabetes and other things, then the brain pathology will will worsen. And of course, we have other supports from different organizations. I'm not going into that detail. And this is a presentation from Uppsala University. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.